Is that gold was never found in Skagway. All the gold from the gold rush was actually found 600 miles up through that pass in the Yukon territory near Dawson City. So 100,000 people got the gold fever and came up here. The reason they chose Skagway was because for 1,000 miles up and down this coast, Skagway is the only place that has a deep enough port and a pass through those mountains there. So it became a natural drop-off or gateway to the Klondike for the gold rush. What the people didn't know was when they got to Skagway, they still had another 600 miles to go to Dawson City. So they had to make a choice. There were two trails, one out of Skagway, the White Pass Trail, or one about 9 miles west out of the town of Dyea called the Chilkoot Trail. The Chilkoot Trail was shorter, 33 miles as compared to 45 miles, but it was a lot steeper. There were avalanches. You couldn't take any pack animals. They couldn't make it up. But the White Pass Trail, even though it was longer and not as steep, had a lot of bandits on it. So they said, whatever trail you chose, you wish you'd chosen the other one. There was no good way to go. So Canada made a law that every miner had to bring a year's worth of supplies with them, which came to about a ton of goods. So they had to carry them or pack them or however they could get them through. Well, you could hire local natives to do packing if you could afford it, but most people would just carry maybe 50 pounds and make 40 trips, which took months and months for them to get through the pass, and it was the dead of winter when they got up there. Now, we get up there, I'll show you just how horrible conditions were for them. There are a lot more women and men than men in Alaska, so ladies, if you're interested, the odds are good. But the goods are odd. Just saying. There's, on the other side of the RV park is the Skagway Public School. This year, the graduating class was 3. One young man, 2 young ladies. They probably had a really good prom. Actually, I'm told that they are invited on board one of the cruise ships for their graduation party, so that's nice. Coming up on a couple of little lakes here, one on the right and another just past that on the left. It used to be one lake before they built the highway. They're called the Black Lakes because of their color. That dark color is caused from the needles of the pine trees. The needles fall in the water and they contain a chemical called tannin. So back through that valley to the right, really cloudy there, but there is a glacier, the Denver Glacier's back there. That's actually the northernmost edge of the Juneau ice fields. They come all the way up here. And on this side, on the other side of the bridge, it's just sitting on the ground, and that's because it spans an active earthquake fault. We have 2 to 3 small earthquakes every day up here, but they're just too small to feel. But if we had a large one, this bridge is designed to kind of roll with it. It wouldn't be secure so that it wouldn't crack and break. It spans 110 feet across the William Moore Creek, which is 180 feet down. So if you're afraid of heights, just do what I do, close your eyes.
Single-sided cantilever bridge.
The trees here are just as old as the trees that are hundreds of feet tall in Skagway. These trees are covered with snow and ice, and they're kind of stunted. They can't really grow because of the conditions. However, there are still some over 100-year-old trees that are maybe 5-6 feet tall. This is called the Windy Arm of Lake Tagish. It's actually a huge lake. It's 60 miles long, and it wraps behind those mountains almost all the way down to Skagway. Technically, it's not really a desert because the humidity level isn't low enough, but looks pretty cool, huh?
Dogsledding.
Oh, gig on the other one. Whoa. All right, so can you please put your both feet on the pedal and don't let it go?
Don't let it go.
Don't let it go, Sam.
You have your instructions.
All right, let it go. Zero Fahrenheit, minus 20 Celsius. So that's why we have the pools. Dogs don't sweat like humans, they only lose heat by the tongue of their feet. So if you let them stand in the water, the quickest way for them to cool off. That's why also the ride's only a mile long. After that, they need a good 15 minutes to cool off. Yeah. In the winter, though, they can run 100 miles straight.
100 miles?
Yeah. These are my dogs, they need a little more training to get there. We're probably gonna start doing smaller races this winter. 1,000 miles. Jeep! Jeep! Oh, Avenger, leave him alone. Those two are best buddies, they just like to argue a lot, they never fight. Is it like this man?
Like a married couple, you think, huh?
It's kinda like that, but it's not as dusty and it's way colder.
What's the main difference between the
Alaskan? All right, Ian, come on. That's enough.
Malamutes are really big, really furry, and they were used a lot for carrying freight back in the days.
Yeah.
I really don't think anyone uses the Malamutes anymore. For dog setting, they're mostly show dogs now. Alaskan Huskies were bred a lot with hunting dogs, so they're way faster. Maybe not quite as strong, but they're the best long-distance racing dogs. Second little pool break. They'll eat maybe 4 cups of kibbles a day, but it's kibbles made for specially made for them, so really high protein, high fat kibbles.
Kibbles is like a dog biscuit or
like dog food, like regular dog food. And then in the winter they need so much protein, we'll mix it with raw meat.
Yeah.
And tons of oil.
Tons of oil.
Yeah, and everything we always give them is always mixed with water, so it's always kind of a soup.
Yep.
To make sure they're really, really well hydrated. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right.
Tell him to go left or right.
Oh. There's a rock there, don't know. They're really like best friends when they're not running. And the reason why the little blonde guy needs to be with Avenger, the black guy, is because he's the only one that can handle him. Any other dog will just start dragging. Yeah, so they need to be together. Only in the summer. In the winter, they don't do that because they run enough. They don't have a surplus of energy.
Yeah.
You breed your own dog?
Sorry?
You breed your own dog?
Yeah. Once in a while, we'll buy one just to kind of mix in the genetic, but try to raise as many breed our own. All right. Thanks so much for coming.
That was awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. That was so fun.
You find a new friend there, Lucas. Uh-oh, Tilly's gonna be jealous.
Tilly's definitely really jealous. She saw this.
She doesn't have to know.
Yeah, we'll just keep it safe from the dog. She's so cute.
And that one could be snowy.
Today you have joined us for our one-way trip from Fraser, British Columbia down to Skagway, Alaska. We will be descending nearly 3,000 feet in elevation today on nearly 27.7 miles of narrow gauge track.
This is the tormented valley. These trees are 100 years old. Just stunted.
While it doesn't look very wide, it is actually very long. Summit Lake is actually 4.5 miles long. It could be up to anywhere between 200 and 250 feet deep in some areas. For all of you fishermen on board, the answer is yes, there are fish in this lake. There are lake trout and Arctic grayling. Coming up to Five Flats, which are in Canada, Yukon Territory, British Columbia, Alaska, and then the United States. You will then see two additional flags, the Canadian flag and the United States flag, and a bronze obelisk marking the international border. You will then see a sign that reads White Pass elevation 2,888 feet. A narrow trail. This is part of the actual trail trotted down by thousands of Stampeders making their way up to the pass during the gold rush. Now this path is not much wider than your train aisle in your coach car. This aisle, keep in mind, was used for two ways with loaded pack animals. Now after you see that sign that says Trail of 98, we will be entering into our first tunnel of the day. This tunnel is 670 feet long and will become very dark once inside. After we exit the tunnel, make sure to take a lookout to your right and you will see our famous steel cantilever bridge.
She said.
Now looking out to your right, you can see our famous steel cantilever bridge. When it was constructed in 1901, it was the tallest standing railroad bridge of its kind in the entire world, standing at 215 feet high. That we retired this bridge back in 1969. This bridge is one of the reasons why the White Pass and Yukon Route Railroad was designated an International Historic Civil Engineering Landmark, which means that this railroad that you are riding on today ranks up with the Statue of Liberty, the Eiffel Tower, and even the Panama Canal. It said that 3,000 animals died by falling off of the trails, breaking their legs and backs, drowning in the river, or plain just being starved to death. So if you look at old pictures of the White Pass Trail, you will see a lot of dead horses lying alongside the Skagway River. This is one reason why the White Pass Trail also became known as the Dead Horse Trail. You will have a great view of the train as it exits the tunnel, going over this bridge and wrapping around the mountainside.
Thank you.
milepost 14, which is Glacier Station, where we will be making our sharpest curve of the day, going to the right and going over a bridge.
That way.
We did drop off some hikers earlier today. Now we will be making just a momentary stop to pick these hikers up, and then we will be back down on our way. Topple 6,000 feet to the valley floor. We are coming up to the gravesite of two of those workers that were killed during a blasting accident that happened when a 500-ton boulder came crashing down the mountainside, instantly killing those two workers and their two pack mules. Now, these two men's names were Al Janot and Maurice Dunn. Sadly, there was no effort of ever trying to recover these bodies. Instead, a black cross was placed in the middle of the rock in memory of those two workers. Michael J. Haney, a foreman of the railroad, said no railroad worker could expect a finer monument than that. The kids came up here on a reunion trip, took the train, begged the conductor to stop the train, climbed across the canyon with paint buckets in tow, and painted that onto Alaska with Buchanan on that rock face.
Whirlpool section of the river.
Now this is class 6 rapids that have never been successfully navigated before. Now after you see these rapids, continue looking down and you will be able to see the remains of Brackett's Toll Road.
Rapids that have never been successfully navigated. Oh, I've never heard of class 6 rapids.
We are now traveling through Rocky Point, milepost 6.9 on those rail maps. Now, this point in the construction of the railroad, the workers came across their first main obstacle, a solid wall of granite standing 120 feet tall. Now, the workers had to use 250 tons of black blasting powder to remove this granite. This is enough powder to fill 44 of our passenger coaches today. Now after we exit Rocky Point, we will have a clearing on our right-hand side. You will be able to see the Denver Glacier Bridge that we will be traveling over in just one short mile. Now before we exit that clearing, you will want to look over your right-hand shoulder and you will have an amazing view back down into the Skagway Harbor. Now we did drop some more hikers off this earlier today, so we will be making one more momentary stop. So again, I do ask that everyone does please stay on board.
Pass, White Pass, that is where we took our tour.
Now we're moving.
On the bus up the left side, home on the train down the right side.
You know what's even better, Mom? Chum sockeye.
You know all about our salmon now, don't
you? Yeah. Okay. Show them do it. Show them your king.
They've got it.
Hey, come on, let's do it.
Let's see if Grandma can do it.
Chum.
Sockeye.
King.
Ring.
Oh, silver.
Silver.
Pink.
That's five.
Chum, sockeye, king, silver, and pink.
Yay. Good job.
Yes, sir.
You're setting up a live band.
Cool.
Who's that? Is that Ian?
Let me guess. It's Regina and the Howlcats.
No.
I'm pretty sure it is.
What is this bald eagle looking for?
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Regina. We are the Half Castle. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah.